answer question. Am I right? Okay, so today we are going to start with question answers of chapter 3. So let's start. Okay, Palak?
Ma'am, very short ka fourth.
Very short ka fourth. Okay, name the process of rearing of silk worm for obtaining silk. All right. Who wants to give the answer?
Sericulture.
Have you guys searched? Raise your hands. And only one will unmute himself.
Sericulture.
Whose name I will call? No other.
Sericulture.
Yes, it is sericulture. Okay, name the process of rearing of silkworm. This is sericulture. Now let's move towards the short question answers. Who wants to tell the first one what is mean by selective breeding?
Ma'am, can I?
Saksham Sen wants to give the answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Saksham, you may. Good to hear from you. Please let me
know. What is meant by selective? Page number 34.
Okay. Everybody.
The two individuals.
They're on page number 34. Let them know.
Then second paragraph.
Okay. Page number 34, second paragraph on the left side.
These are thin crossed mat to reproduce to obtain new breed of the animal. Animal having desirable characteristics of both the parents. This is called selective breeding.
Yes. Okay. So you will not write bees, you will write sheep. Okay. Sheep are crossed, made to reproduce, to obtain new breed of the animals having desirable characteristics of both the parents. This is known as selective breeding.
All right. Let me repeat the answer.
It's given on page number 34. You don't know line number 4. Okay. Second para. You don't have to write these are then crossed. Sheep are crossed to obtain new breed of the animals having desirable characteristics of both the parent. This is known as selective breeding. Okay.
Ma'am.
Individuals of weight beta. Two individuals of desirable characteristics.
Ma'am,
are
now
selected
I...
as parents. Okay, yes, Pari.
Ma'am, may I? Ma'am, what is soaring? Mean by soaring, ma'am.
Individuals of desirable characteristics are selected as parents, and then these are crossed. Okay, then these are crossed, made to reproduce. To obtain the new breed of animals which are having the desired characteristics, and this is known as selective breeding. You may get a better variety from this. Okay. Next, what is this scouring? Just raise your hand.
Ma'am.
Don't shout.
Ma'am.
Just raise your hands.
Can I?
These questions you have to do in your copy. Okay. Not very short, but both the short, long, and hot you have to do in your copy. And those who are having copies in the school premises, then they may do their work in the pen pages and later on you guys may paste. Okay? So let's start with the next question. Scouring. I have raised their hand.
Ma'am, may I tell?
Ma'am, can I tell?
What I said?
Ma'am,
Ranjan.
You don't have to say ma'am, me. Just have to raise your hand simply, as we do in the class. Okay, I want to hear from Ritika. Yes, Ritika.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, page number 34.
Okay.
Foreign.
Page number 34, everyone. I hope you guys are having...
Ma'am, the voice of Ritika is not coming.
Scoring second paragraph.
Everybody keep yourself muted and switch on your videos. Switch on your videos quickly, everyone. I want to see you guys. Very good. All my obedient students have started their videos. Very nice. Good to see you all. Sit up straight. Backbone should be straight. Sit like a smart student. Wow, very nice. It gives me a feel of a class when I see you guys. Sakshi, sit at another place. I'm not able to see you, Sakshi. Same with you.
Ma'am, Ritika ki voice nahi aa rahi.
Ritika, speak a little bit louder and now tell me the answer, Ritika.
Page number 34.
Okay.
Scoring. Second paragraph, the process of washing the feet of sheep to remove dust, dirt, sweat, grease, etc. is known as scoring. Nowadays, scoring is done by machine.
Yes. Okay. Page number 34, step 2, scouring, second paragraph. All right. Now let's move towards the next question. Lower down your hand for the previous one. Okay. I'm having, I think, a new student, Ara Saharia.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Ara. Unmute yourself. Unmute yourself, Ara.
Ma'am, it's Arsh.
Ma'am. Sorry? Ma'am, it's Arsh. Arsh. You have written A-R-A-H. This is the spelling you have written here.
Wrong spelling.
Okay, your name is Arsh, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you are from which school, dear?
Ma'am, I was...
You are being admitted?
Ma'am, I don't know.
You don't know. Okay, fine. So, I'll do one thing. I'll add your name in 7th A only. Okay? May I know the spelling of your name, please? Vikroga, sit at your place. Okay, fine. I'll take now. Okay, Arsh, we have done first two chapters. And third is going on, fiber to fabric. Have you got your book set, Arsh? Arsh, are you having your book set?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. All right, Arsh. So, just go through these two chapters. And Arsh, I have made videos also for explaining these two chapters for explanation. You may get it on the YouTube. You just have to search with my name, Arsh Muskan Khatpani. Okay? And I'm your science teacher. I'm going to teach you science. All right? You just have to search with my name on YouTube. You will get the videos.
Okay.
Everything I have explained for these two chapters over there. And for homework, etc., go to school and they will help you out. Okay? And then too, if you find any problem, let me know. I will provide you the number of any one of the students here.
Okay.
All right. So,
let's
do the next one. Is there anyone, a student, Bita? If it is any, let me know. Okay? And get the name added to me. All right. So, let's start it again. We were doing the short question answers. Give two characteristics of wool. Okay, Varsha and Vaishali have raised their hand first. Yes, Varsha, Vaishali. Everybody switch on your videos. I'm not going to say it again. Yes, Varsha, Vaishali. Unmute yourself. Give me the response.
Ma'am, can I give now?
Please.
Ma'am, your voice is not clear.
Just speak.
Ma'am, it is on page number 33. Paragraph wool, second paragraph, wool se lekar jaise line tak.
Okay, page number?
33.
And wrong answer.
Please open page number 33.
मैम थर्ड वाला करेक्टर्स ऑफ करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ होल के लिए सेट नंबर 33
यस टू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ होल
मैम पैराग्राफ नंबर सेकंड
यस रीड आउट
The wool has a high tensile strength and has a high elasticity. It can absorb large amount of water. It is lightweight and can be easily dyed. It is considerably resilient.
Fine. Perfectly correct. Okay, fine. Okay, you are correct. Okay, these two characteristics you guys have to write. Have you marked Kanish? Kanish, have you marked? Page number 33, wool. Second paragraph. Kanish Mehra? Have you marked? Give me the response, Kanish. Where are you going? Keep your device at a place. Yes, Kanish, unmute yourself. Okay, wool has a high tensile strength and high elasticity. It can absorb large amounts of water. It is lightweight, can be dyed easily. All these other characteristics. Next, what is silk? How it is obtained? What is silk? How it is
obtained?
Yes, I want to hear from Palak. Yes, Palak. Unmute yourself, Palak.
Yes, ma'am. On page number 36.
Okay, page number 36, everyone, open. Open page number 36, everyone. Yes.
Ma'am, kar liya open.
Yes, boliye, Palak.
Silk is a fine, strong, soft, and shining fiber obtained from silkworm. It is separated from cocoon of silkworm and made of a protein. And silk is the strongest natural fiber.
Yes, this you have to write. Silk is a fine, strong, soft and shining fiber obtained from silkworm and it's separated from the cocoons of silkworm that are reared on large scale. How it is obtained, that is being asked now. Okay, so what you will write, that it is separated from the cocoons of silkworm, okay, that are reared on large scale. Write it down.
Ma'am, repeat the answer.
Yes, I'm repeating. Don't worry, I will provide you the key also later on. Okay, then too, I'm repeating. Silk is a fine, strong, soft and shiny fibers obtained from silkworm. Okay, here you have must have marked. It is separated from the cocoons.
Yes, ma'am.
It is separated from the cocoons. Which are layered on a large scale. Okay, cocoons of silkworm that are layered on large scale. All right, let me discuss the next one now. Why are the cocoons boiled in hot water or heated in ovens? Why are the cocoons boiled in hot water or heated in ovens? Sujal, yes, Sujal. Unmute yourself, Sujal. Sujal and Mani, you may give the response. Why the cocoons are boiled? Or heated in ovens?
Can I? Vanshika.
Yes, Vanshika, you may.
The cocoons are first boiled in hot water, heated in ovens to keep the larvae inside. If the larvae are not killed and allowed to grow, they will break the cocoon, thereby reducing the length of silk fiber.
Cocoons are boiling, oxygen allows to kill the pupa inside.
Page number 37, from cocoon to silk, first point boiling.
Yes, page number 37. Everybody open page number 37.
Yes, ma'am.
From cocoon.
Boiled on ovens, boiled in water and chicken ovens to kill the larva inside.
Ma'am, which paragraph?
37, from cocoon to silk. Topic, cocoon to silk, first point boiling. First point boiling.
Yes, ma'am, mil gaya, tick kar liya.
ठीक है
कोकून
हॉट वाटर एंड चिटिटी नर्वस टू किल द लार्वा इनसाइड इफ द लार्वा नॉट किल्ड देन दे विल ब्रेक द कोकून ओके
यस मैम
ओके नेक्स्ट
मैम फाइबर तक लिख लें
ओके यू मे नेक्स्ट इज व्हाई डू वी नॉट वेट फॉर द सिल्क मोथ्स टू हैच एंड देन बॉइल द कोकून Don't we wait for the silk moth to hatch? Yes, Vanshika?
Vanshika.
Ma'am, may I?
May I?
Where is Chitra Vashish today? Where is Diksha? Yes, Diksha?
Ma'am, she is at 10.
Diksha?
Chitra Vashish.
Ma'am. Okay, I want to hear from Pari Garg. Yes, Pari.
Ma'am.
Pari, give me the response.
Meow.
Pari.
Meow.
Okay. All right. Let me hear from Palak. Yes, Palak. Unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, first we take from the question, the silk moth to page number 37.
Everybody, please open page number 37. Page number 37, everyone. Yes, Pala, continue.
Ma'am, first we will write, we boil the cuckoo, we not wait for the silk moth to hatch, first we boil the cuckoo because if the larvae are not killed and allowed to grow, then they will break the cuckoo thereby.
And they are reducing the length of silk fiber. Okay? So up to here you will write in the next one, and in the first question you have to write up to inside only, just to kill the larva, okay? Because the next question again he has asked. All right, Sujal, don't write up to fiber in that one. All right, next question. Why do we not wait for the silk moth? Okay, we have done this. Seventh, why do we need to boil the cocoon for extraction of silk? It's the same question actually. ओके इसमें आप सेरेसिन के बारे में बता दोगे ओके व्हाई डू वी नीड टू बॉइल द कोकून फॉर एक्सट्रैक्शन ऑफ सेल यू विल टेल अबाउट सेरेसिन ओवर हियर एंड दिस टाइम आई वांट टू हियर फ्रॉम सुजल निर्माणी यस सुजल प्लीज अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ वेयर आर द
मैम मैं कह रहा था कि रिपीट कर दो सिक्स्थ वाला
Sorry?
मैम सिक्स्थ वाला रिपीट कर दो.
इट्स देयर ओनली ना ऑन द सेम पेज वेयर द प्रीवियस वन वाज.
मैम 37 पे वही द कोकून्स.
हां जी इफ द लावा. फर्स्ट यू हैव टू टेक इट फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन एंड we don't wait for the symptom to hatch, because if the larva are not killed and allowed to grow, then they will break the cocoon, thereby reducing the length of silk fiber. Okay, Sujal?
Okay, ma'am.
All right. Next is, why do we need to boil the cocoons? Just to loosen the saracen. Okay? We need to boil the cocoons for extraction of silk, because the hot water softens the silk gum saracen. It's also given over here in this same paragraph on page number 37, boiling. Third last line from the bottom of paragraph, boiling. The hot water softens the silk gum saracen so as to allow the unwinding of silk fiber as one continuous thread. Okay, I hope everybody must have answered, marked page number 37, first boiling, last third line. Okay, the hot water softens the silk gum saracen so as to allow the unwinding of silk fiber as one continuous thread. Now come to the short answers. Why does shearing not hurt the sheep? Why does sheep not hurt the... I want to hear from everyone. Please raise your hand. Where is Asta? Where is Pari? Where is Diksha? Abhijit Kasanna? Where are the students? Why only these are raising their hands? I'm having so many in my class.
Ma'am, I...
Oh, I want to hear from someone else. Sujal, I know you are attentive.
Ma'am, ye wala aata hai.
Yes, Varsha Vishali, you may tell. Varsha Vishali, unmute yourself.
Ma'am, it is on page number 34.
Everybody open page number 34.
Ma'am, processing fiber into wool ka step one shearing.
Step one shearing, page number 34. Everyone open up. Open page number 34, all of you. Yes, you may continue.
Ma'am, fourth line, shearing does not hurt the sheep because the uppermost layer of the skin of sheep is dead.
Yes, on the very right side, just above this picture of shearing a sheep, second line, shearing does not hurt the sheep because the uppermost layer of the skin of sheep is dead. Okay? All right, next answer. Differentiate between silk and wool. Differentiate between silk and wool. If I have to give answer in short, just tell them the sources.
Ma'am, first answer repeat kar do.
Ma'am, by their definitions and examples.
34.
Ma'am, हम इस क्वेश्चन को पॉइंट्स में भी लिख सकते हैं ना?
Yes, obviously. आप पॉइंट्स में ही लिखेंगे. डिफरेंशिएट करके
यस मैम लाइन
फर्स्ट आंसर मैम फर्स्ट आंसर
फर्स्ट आंसर इज ऑन पेज नंबर 34 जस्ट अबव द आर यू एबल टू सी द पिक्चर ऑफ शेयरिंग जस्ट अबव दिस सेकंड लाइन फिगर 3.2 इज मेंशनड आफ्टर दैट Shearing does not hurt the sheep because the uppermost layer of the skin of sheep is dead. I have told you this thing now. It doesn't harm them. I have showed you a video also regarding that. Everybody switch on your videos quickly. Switch on your videos. Yes.
1 second.
Next is, let me turn the page. Silk and wool, who can tell me the difference? Saksham Sen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, tell me.
Okay, ma'am.
First, differentiate between the sources.
No.
Yes, Saksham, tell you were right. कहाँ से मिलता है पहला पॉइंट वो दे दो ओके
वूल इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम शिप गॉट यार्ड
यस
एंड सिल्क इज ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम कैटरपिलर सिल्क इज अ Fine, strong, soft, and shining fiber obtained from silkworm.
Yes.
Wool is present as a thick coat of hair on the body of the wool-yielding animals.
Fine.
Okay.
Any other difference anybody can give?
No, ma'am.
May I tell?
Okay, you may.
Ma'am. Page number 33.
Page number 33. All right. Yes.
Ma'am, animal fibers may wool is obtained from fur, hair of sheep, angora goat, Kashmir goat, yak, rabbit, camel, elmite, alpaca. And on last line, silk is obtained from cuckoos of silk.
I mean, second point example करके लिख देंगे.
अब मैं मेक पेज नंबर 36 पे silk is a fine, strong, soft and shining fiber obtained from silk.
I think you guys will be able to write in your own words, okay? That this is luster, having the luster, silk is having the luster, right? Wool is not as lustrous as silk. Okay? Silk is the strongest natural fiber. Again, I repeat myself, silk is the strongest natural fiber. Wool is not as strong as silk. Alright? And for obtaining silk, we have to kill them. Kill the organic. We don't have to do this for wool. Okay? That we are getting
silk का example क्या लिखेंगे silkworms
sorry
silk के examples क्या लिखेंगे silkworm
हाँ silk moth okay all right so now I'm going to share my PDF with you guys
okay ma'am नहीं मैम मैं तो आपसे मार्क की करवा दो ऐसे मार्क कर
yes ma'am ऐसे discussion में अच्छा लग रहा है
मैम आप तो पीडीएफ दिखा दो
चलिए लास्ट में व्हेन वी विल फिनिश
मैम
कोई बात नहीं
मैम पीडीएफ दिखा दो मैम फिर तो क्लास ओवर होने वाली है।
मैम डिस्कसिंग में टाइम चल जाएगा।
मैम टाइम पास हो जाएगा।
मैम क्लास भी ओवर हो गई
है। आप तो पीडीएफ दिखा दो।
पीडीएफ